API 10D restoring force test is designed to measure the ability of a centralizer to centralize casing inside the weld bore. At the end of the test, we produce a low deflection curve of the performance of the centralizer, and this is used to create a restoring force figure.
I'm here today to verify that the casing centralizer tests which are being conducted are done in accordance with the appropriate API standard, that's API 10D. I will witness each step of that inspection process. Centek will produce a number of test certificates which will be presented to me for signing, stamping and dating.
The API 10D restoring force test for the 958 12 and a quarter centralizers demonstrated the superior performance of the Centek centralizer and the importance of including centralizer plastic deformation into the restoring force result. Centek's restoring force was over £3,000 higher than the DHP centralizer, mostly due to the DHP centralizer losing half an inch in diameter. Similarly, the Sledgehammer centralizer's restoring force was £3,300 lower than the Centek product and lost 0.5 inches in diameter. The DHP and Sledgehammer results, using our load deflection curve for restoring force, were both well over 80% less than their data sheets. The standoff calculated for the Centek product was 78.4%, well above the API standard of 67%. The Sledgehammer and DHP products did not meet the API standard of £1,600 restoring force and therefore failed the minimum API requirement.